I burn for you, Daphne.
And cut. Oh my gosh, guys, amazing. Such passion. That was great.
The SNL sketch with host Reed Jean Page spoofing the filming of a Bridgerton sex scene.
Welcome to the show. My name is Reggae Jean Page.
Highlighted the importance of qualified intimacy coordinators. A hilarious sketch on last night's Saturday Night Live with host Reed Jean Page revealed how Bridgerton sex scenes are choreographed with an SNL twist, of course.
I think we'll be okay without these intimacy coordinators. We know each other's boundaries, we'll just do what we rehearsed.
Okay, great. Well, have a great sex scene, have fun, we'll be here.
Yeah.
Excellent.
The February 20th, 2021 episode took full advantage of the Bridgerton breakout star's sex appeal and charisma, judging from the wildly enthusiastic live audience, which was more than happy to see Page reprise his role as Simon Bassett, Duke of Hastings, even if it was in a sketch that illustrated the sometimes absurdly hilarious nature of choreographing on-screen intimacy.
You could just pop on to all fours like this.
Yeah.
Bridgerton season 1 became an immediate smash hit for Netflix upon its premiere on Christmas Day 2020. The Regency-era romance followed the twists and turns of the blossoming relationship and eventual marriage between the Duke of Hastings and Daphne Bridgerton.
With my eldest brother. If that were not enough, I'm also aware of the things a certain writer has recently written of you.
With Paige and co-star Phoebe Dynevor earning accolades for their performances, and the supporting cast also getting quite a bit of buzz. However, viewers really tuned into the bodice ripper for Paige's smoldering on-screen broodiness, as well as Bridgerton's sex scenes, of which there are many.
For a laugh, Daffy, you could say, shh, don't let mom and dad hear us.
Right, we're not brother and sister.
Right, right.
SNL's sketch framed itself as the shooting of a Bridgerton sex scene with Paige's Hastings and Chloe Fineman's Daphne. However, it skewered these scenes by revealing the paradox behind them. The sex scenes on the Netflix series, or any other series or movie, that seem to be so spontaneous and passionate, are really the result of carefully crafted, specifically coordinated simulated sex.
Is Paula back? She's fantastic.
Yes, I feel very, very safe with her.
Unfortunately, Paula had a COVID exposure at a fundraiser for COVID relief, but...
That is all done under the watchful eye of an on-set intimacy coordinator. At least, that's how it normally is, but Saturday Night Live's stand-in intimacy coordinators, played by Mikey Day and Pete Davidson, who have little training and even less tact, make it incredibly awkward as they suggest increasingly inappropriate things for the on-screen couple to try.
Coordinator, this is my nephew Randy, assistant IC.
As the sketch becomes increasingly more cringeworthy thanks to the boundary-less duo, it also pokes fun at the fact that intimacy coordinators are a largely unregulated role in Hollywood. It's a profession that has been exploding in the entertainment industry, especially in the wake of the number Me Too movement, both incredibly necessary and overdue developments.
Nice to meet you.
I think I saw you guys over by the bagel table earlier. I thought you were lighting guys.
Oh yeah, close. We worked in special effects for years.
Yeah, explosions, weird.
Intimacy coordinators play an important role in any production in which there are sex scenes. They're responsible for ensuring that everyone, both cast and crew, feels comfortable and supported while shooting any intimate scenes, and that boundaries are being enforced.
That's great, that's great. You seem very qualified. Now, any questions about the script?
They're also intimately involved in pre-production, from negotiating actors' areas of consent and nudity riders, to establishing what is and isn't okay in regard to shooting simulated sex scenes. Unfortunately, though intimacy coordinators have been part of theatrical productions for quite some time, the role is still new to Hollywood. And, as with any new position, that means an understanding of what exactly it is that intimacy coordinators do isn't solidified, nor is there industry-wide standardized training.
Didn't read, it seemed like a girl show to me.
Yeah, but we get the gist, you two are brother and sister, you're banging each other, good stuff.
No, that's disgusting.
As a result, underqualified intimacy coordinators without proper training sometimes find their way to sets, and that's when things can get awkward, as Pete Davidson and Mikey Day show.
Husband and wife.
Why would you think we were playing brother and sister?
Yeah, I don't know. It's Netflix. They got some dark stuff on there, you know what I mean?
Saturday Night Live has a long history of poking fun at serious subjects. Perhaps their hilariously cringy Bridgerton sex scene spoof will finally inspire Hollywood to give great intimacy coordinators the credit they deserve.
This requires modesty garments be made available, so we got a bunch of beef sleeves and dong bags here for you.